The diverse student body at Ole Miss is represented by the Associated Student Body. A few years ago, some ASB members moved to stop prayer in meetings.
Two senators, I believe he's an agnostic and a Muslim senator, they asked to have it removed, and they actually wrote a resolution to have it removed, and we voted against it. So that's how it all started last year.
The problem wasn't that they were religious, but that the Senate had an exclusively Christian prayer.
I think it's when there is an open prayer to one particular religion that's when we can become exclusionary, and that's what we want to avoid.
Student organizations that are not specific to one religion are in violation of the M Book if they require their members to perform religious acts. What does it mean for these organizations, however, if their members all practice the same faith?
If they are all in a consensus and everybody is okay with it, you know, there's no reason for us to really say, you can't do this. But, you know, what really is important when we step in is when it starts offending someone and when there is that person that's not of that religion and is not okay with it.
For other student organizations, such as residence hall cabinets, this case serves as a model of how to be inclusive.
As far as the invocation goes, I guess it could be an indicator that, yes, the university is, you know, doing its best to be inclusive of all people. But I want people to know that, you know, we were keeping that in mind as well when we were trying to reinstate the invocation. It's not like, oh, we're all the Christians, let's rally up and let's bring this invocation back because we're good old Southern Baptists. No, it was nothing of the sort.
The proposal to reintroduce prayer ended because the Judicial Council had already ruled it unconstitutional before. Reporting from the Ole Miss campus, I'm Norman Seawright for Newswatch.